It's such a busy news day. I don't believe we're back here again talking about the music industry. In this case, we're talking about Pandora. Pandora, folks. Can you tell me, please tell me why Pandora CEO resigned? Why did Pandora CEO resign? That's something I just want to get to talk about, okay? According to people familiar with this story, apparently Pandora CEO is a really giant. Last year, he co-founded Pandora. Apparently, he's the co-founder. Okay, so what I want to actually focus on today's talk is why did this happen? Okay, so think about it. Tim resets relations with the major labels, launch an online demand service, and reforfeited the Pandora balance sheet by securing an investment from from Sirius XM. Okay, the end of an era. So what era are we talking about? According to news reports from Digital Trends last year, when it comes to subscribers, the undisputed king of on-demand streaming is Spotify. Could this be the reason why Pandora CEO decided to drop and get away from it? Because you have competition coming up with Spotify. There's also a lot of competition. Obviously, you have new people jumping on board. This competition is stiff. Now, even Amazon launched a streaming service and Jay-Z's title. Okay, so when you figure the fact that, for example, more than 30 million subscribers now subscribe to Spotify, how can they actually compete? So, to me, that's one of the major reasons Tim stepped down as the CEO of Pandora. The other thing you gotta realize about this music wars is there's niche players involved. There's companies like PODBUM. The track that you're listening to right now is an independent track from PODBUM. What is PODBUM? It's a way for any artist, any producer to produce music and go directly to the fans using podcasts, using live streams, kind of like what you're listening to right now. Imagine being able to access your fans' music through a podcast. So mastering the art of podcasts, recording podcasts and producing hit shows or marketing campaigns is what PODBUM does. Full service digital marketing consultancy. They have everything that's needed to make, create, distribute and analyze podcasts. So on the one hand, you have people like PODBUM competing. Then you have other players in the industry. So you tell me, in this kind of environment, that it makes sense to just let people take over your market share. So that's what's going on with Pandora. Tell me if I'm wrong, if Tim did not see the writing on the wall, did not see that the music libraries, did not see that Apple Music, did not see what Spotify was doing either. They didn't see that. To me, that's what happened. This is what happens when you let Spotify get into your market and steal all your subscribers. Take all your subscribers where you don't have any mind share. So let me tell you something. What needs to happen now? Where is this industry heading? If you're an artist in this industry, what do you think is going to happen? Radio. So according to this Digital Trends article, arguably the biggest area where Spotify finds itself, okay, behind its competitors is radio. Radio. So what is radio? Is radio the same radio that what it used to be down way back when? I don't think so. Choosing the artist on Spotify called up similar artists. Okay? So it ended up mainly focused on somebody else's music. So the jazz station, for one, does this. It's still worthwhile listening experience. So this is just analysis. Now you go and you look at Apple. Apple's music preference for lunch human really helps radio style programming. And so is the thing that PODBUM is doing. You can release your own podcast. With your own podcast, you can reach directly to your fans. And your fans engage with your content. And if they like what they hear, they can actually subscribe to your podcast on a monthly basis, a subscription fee, where you're streaming and releasing your own independent music directly to your fans. Now, you tell me, if that isn't something that any music fan would crave. So when you ask me, why did Pandora quit? Why did Pandora quit? What made Pandora drop the towel, turn in the towel, go home? Mission accomplished. What happened? Can you tell me what happened that made him quit the music industry, given the fact that he was also an artist? What happened? What happened? He officially out and made company shakeup. What shakeup are you talking about? It doesn't matter that he got almost $500 million from Sirius. Sirius is saying we're going to invest in Pandora. But yet, Pandora decides to leave. The CEO decides to step down. I'll tell you something else that I think happened with Pandora that nobody's talking about. You know what it is? They're operating something called terrestrial radio, which is completely a different model than the streaming media that Spotify is known for, or Apple Music for that matter. So the royalty basis when it comes to terrestrial radio has not been traditionally friendly to recording artists and music creators. So that's why I keep preaching about PODBUM, P-O-D-B-U-M. Again, P-O-D-B-U-M. That's the platform that you want to take advantage of right now. It's called PODBUM. Go ahead and follow PODBUM on the socials. Okay? Go to PODBUM on Twitter. Follow PODBUM, because all PODBUM is trying to do is make it easy for artists to take over their recording careers. With the music industry in disruption at the scale that is currently happening, it behooves every artist to be their own record label. You gotta be your own record label. There's no way around it. You gotta be your own record label. Don't tell me that you can't be a record label. Don't tell me that you can't be a record label. You're gonna let your industry disappear right in front of you. Right in front of you. Okay? Now let's talk about subscriptions. As you can see, Apple Music costs the industry standard $10 per month, as does Spotify Premium, Tidal Premium, Pandora's new on-demand service, and just about every other on-demand subscription on the block. Amazon Unlimited costs $10, $8 with the Prime subscription. Apple originally hoped to undercut its competitors by offering an $8 or even a $5 a month, but the plan was derailed by the major labels that own the rights to the vast majority of the catalog. You see this right here? The labels own the vast majority of the catalog. So let me ask you this again, if you're an artist. If you're an artist and you really want to take charge of your music industry, what are you going to do? Are you going to sit out there and let the labels dictate what happens online? Or are you going to take your career in your own hands? Right now, go ahead and go to www.podbum.com. What I want to see you is like, share, subscribe, follow PODBUM on Twitter, send and get into a newsletter where you can get up-to-the-minute hacks. These hacks are just for you to help you understand what exactly is going on in the recording industry, okay? There's no time to waste. There's no time to waste. Go ahead and put in your name, your information, and subscribe. Once you subscribe, when you need to have it, we're going to tell you the secret hacks, okay? By signing up, you'll get access to our industry music business podcasting secret newsletter. This secret newsletter is jam-packed with hacks, original hacks that can enable you to understand the dynamics of what's actually going on in the music industry right now. The music industry is witnessing what we call music wars. Music wars. The only way you can get this done where you become the winner and become your own boss in this industry is by becoming your own boss. Okay? I cannot stress this any further. Now, this is our CEO of PODBUM. Look at what he is. He's an army veteran. He's delivering Apex ROI on your ass band while he's growth hacking the music wars. I mentioned this before. There's a music war going on. You think there's not a music war? What happens when about every, according to this article, Digital Trends, about every other on-demand subscription service on the block, Amazon Unlimited Music costs $10. $8 with a Prime subscription. Apple originally hoped to undercut its competitors by offering its service for $8 or even $5. But the plan was derailed by the major labels that own the rights to the vast majority of the catalog. Okay? To make Music or Spotify for this subscription. A bit more about appealing to me. Both companies offer special family packs that allow customers to add to the 6 individual accounts granted. So let me tell you something, guys. This is a major fit, all right? You just got to understand the industry is completely changed. It's not what it used to be before, all right? So let me tell you what PODBUM does right here, okay? So this is according to people familiar with the industry. So PODBUM is a private label boutique music application and app. It allows artists to disrupt the Jurassic music industry and unlock hidden value to music fans everywhere. PODBUM app is available on iOS and Android platforms. Okay, the founder of PODBUM, the world's first direct-to-fans record label. PODBUM is the world's first direct-to-fans digital record label. We do this. PODBUM does it by going directly. It believes the music model is Jurassic and ripe for disruption. It obviously is ripe for disruption when you have the CEO of the CEO of Pandora basically saying, I'm done. I am out of this. I don't want nothing to do with the music industry no more. Okay? This is top news. This is trending everywhere. So you tell me why this is the situation. Why is Pandora's CEO stepping down? Why is he stepping down? What happened? I'll tell you what happened. The music industry is witnessing a dramatic shift. Okay? The value chain no longer resides where you think it resides. The value chain now resides with those that are music producers. In other words, you do not need a record label to go directly to the fans. And because you do not need a record label to go to the fans, you control your destiny. So go right now to www.podbomb.com and continue this conversation.